everybody always says, well, how do you get everything done? Are you crazy? You don't. You could have a 30-hour day and you'd still have projects to start, places to go, people to call. Yes? You will never get it all done, and there will always be more things to do than time to do it. So if something has to go, what's it going to be? See, I like to practice what I call purposeful abandonment. Have you ever asked yourself the question in all seriousness, if I didn't do this at all, would anybody notice? That's a really darn good question. Part of what we have to do is learn to recognize that productivity is not about quantity. It's not about the number of things that you do in a day. I think time management training has done people an incredible disservice over the years in teaching that somehow activity equates to accomplishment. Every day you must move a mountain. You have to ask yourself, if I do nothing else today, what are the two most important things that I need to get done and get to work and get moving?
A lot of people don't like to hear about productivity. They think, why in the world would I want to be more productive? I'm killing myself as it is. But productivity doesn't have to be your enemy. It can be your friend. It can help you achieve your goals faster. It can help you have better results for the amount of time that you have.
Laura Stack, certified speaking professional, is known internationally as the Productivity Pro. She helps people leave the office earlier with less stress and more to show for.
It means not multitasking. If you're supposed to be finishing that project, that report summary by noon, and it's 8 o'clock now, a lot of people get in there and say, okay, let's see, I'm going to start that report. No, need a latte to get me going. Go to Starbucks, get a latte, come back. Okay, where was I? Oh, yeah, meeting notes. They're in here somewhere. Oh, look, here's the supply order. Oh, forgot to fax that. Better go do that right now. Here, fax the supply order. Back over here. Where was I? Oh, yeah, meeting. Where? Okay, here's my meeting notes. Oh, it doesn't have those stats. I should check my email, because Karen emailed the report from the meeting last week. They'll be there. Let's see where. Ooh, 8 new messages. I should check them. Where was I? Oh, good. Meeting notes. Okay. Oh, here they are. Oh, look at that. She doesn't have the statistics in there. I can't. I'll just call her and say, Karen, you know, I really... What? Oh, tickets for the show. You're kidding. How did you get those? What time? Oh, 4 o'clock? I'd love to. Oh, thank you. I'll see you then. Okay. Oh, dude, stats for the meeting. Oh, voicemail. Gee, I'm going to do it myself. Calculator. Oh, my gosh. Look at this drawer. This is a mess. Can't find anything. I should clean it. Oh, my gosh. Oh, John, hi. It's 12. Oh, time for the meeting? I just seem to get anything done today. I just don't know what's going on.
Laura is the president of the Productivity Pro Incorporated, an international consulting firm in Denver, Colorado, that specializes in productivity improvement in high-stress organizations. She is one of a handful of professional speakers whose business focuses solely on time management and productivity topics.
And now with all of the blackberries or crackberries, as I like to call them, you bring your crackberry home now. You know, and I talked to one gal who has a running joke. She said, yeah, three people sleep in my bed at night. And I'm like, really? She said, yeah, me, my husband, and my BlackBerry. Because she wakes up in the morning and she's checking it first thing. And she says it has become so addictive that it's now this compulsion that she just cannot shut it. She goes, it was so pathetic. I went to Disneyland with my boys and I'm standing in the line checking my BlackBerry. You know, and people know that they have a problem when they don't have these boundaries, but it becomes so compulsive. The technology is so controlling them that it almost becomes like an addiction. If you brought masking tape from home and you put it across your little system tray on the bottom of your monitor so you couldn't see the little envelope popping up, and you turned off your alerts, bring a little alarm clock, set it for 30 minutes, would you be able to not check? You'd be doing this. You'd be going through major withdrawal. See, and what happens when you have, we jokingly in my field now of productivity, we call this email OCD. Because you're working on something, right? You're doing a report, doing a spreadsheet, whatever, and you get the little pop-up. What are you going to do? I'm going to check it. And you can't help it. You're just dying. So you have to figure out what a reasonable alternative looks like for you. And what do you use? Lotus, GroupWise, Outlook? What do you use? Outlook. So if you go into your tools, options, email options, advanced email options, and uncheck the four boxes that says when a new item arrives in my inbox, do the following. Play a sound. Put up an alert. Change a cursor. Put it. Oh, my gosh. No wonder we are so obsessed.
Laura is.
What happens to me every day that keeps me from doing what I know I should be doing? See, in my opinion, there's only two pains in the world of productivity. One is the pain of discipline, and one is the pain of regret. Is it easy being productive? No, I tell people all the time, this is hard. I'm talking about some things that are difficult for self-control and self-discipline. But it is a lot easier to get into work, bam, get going on that most important activity instead of putting it off and working on it at 5 o'clock because I want to be out of there and go home and spend time with my husband and my three young children. That's the pain of regret, and I'd much rather work harder than have that pain of regret at the end.
So we had this fast track life. And I led a very fast track life. You know, I wanted to make Daddy proud of me. He was successful. I wanted to be successful too. I graduated high school a year early. I was 16. I went and I did my undergraduate degree. I was 19. I finished my master's in business. I was 21. When I missed my daughter's first steps, I was 26. I was burned out, not on track, not following my values or my priorities. And people say, "What's your hurry? Why are we going so fast?" I have no idea. All I know was that I was on a quick road to nowhere. I was chasing it without even really knowing what it was.
They're over here.